You are not going to want to forget this tip. What's up, plant lovers? Welcome back to Mind the Leaves. Today we're talking all about winter plant care. Winter can be a really trying time for us plant lovers. The sun is much lower, the humidity is down, and our plants can really suffer. But I'm gonna give you some really good tips to help you and your plants get through this chilly season. Let's start with some lighting tips. Because the days are so short and the sun is so weak, it's a good idea to move your plants right up to a window so that they can have as much sunlight as possible. But do be careful, because cold and freezing windows can damage leaves if they're touching them. So make sure to put your plants up close to a window, but keep them back about 2 or 3 inches just to make sure you're not running into any freezing damage. Likewise, try to keep your plants away from heat vents and cold drafts. If you keep your plants right next to a glass door that opens continuously, you could run into some problems with your plants. In winter, the light's already not optimal, so don't let anything stand in your way. Make sure that you're cleaning your windows, the dust off of your leaves, and any glass containers that hold air plants or terrariums so that you can optimize the amount of light that you do have. If you find that you're really struggling for light in the winter, it's a good idea to try to supplement with a grow light just to help get them through. Now let's go over some watering tips. You are not going to want to forget this tip. It is extremely important as a general rule that you cut back the frequency that you're watering your plants. Sadly, overwatering is one of the biggest killers of houseplants over the winter time. Most of our houseplants will take a winter rest, where they either stop growing completely or at least significantly slow down their growth. And because they're not getting nearly as much sun and they're not growing as much, they certainly don't need as much water. So although of course it's tough to say because you should be checking your soil, anything that you were previously watering about once a week, you're probably going to be watering every other week. But something I absolutely have to mention is that not all houseplants take a winter rest. You might notice that some of your plants just keep growing, keep pushing out new leaves. Some houseplants do this, and in fact, some plants have their strongest growing season in the winter. So for any plant like that that you're seeing lots of fresh new growth still coming, just keep up with your regular watering schedule. If you're finding this video helpful, go ahead and plant your finger on that like button and let's get back to it. Succulents and cacti especially do not need a lot of water in the winter season. For most succulents, you can water them about once a month. For cacti, however, I do not water my cacti at all during the growing season. Completely cut that out until spring. But if you have a specific cacti that starts looking extremely shriveled over the season, you can give that guy a little water just to give him a boost. Likewise, all of your houseplants that are going to be taking a winter rest do not need any fertilizer. You can hold off on that until spring. But of course, for any plant that is still actively growing, you can keep them on their regular fertilizing schedule. Now, I just think that this is a good tip for any season, but especially in winter, please make sure that you are watering your houseplants with lukewarm, room temperature water so that you aren't shocking the roots. Okay, let's talk a little bit about air. So in the summertime, we all love to open our windows and let the summer breeze roll in. And of course, our plants absolutely love that because they love to have the air circulating around them. But in the winter, we shut everything up and they pretty much have to suffer with our dry heat. So if you have one, just bust out a fan and let their leaves flow in the breeze. They will absolutely love that air circulation. One of the worst parts of winter is the significant humidity drop. I mean, it's easy for us to keep our humidity at around 50 or 60 in the summer, but in the winter, at least for me, it plummets to about 20% if I'm not doing something. So whether it's with a humidifier or any other method, do try to keep your relative humidity at about 50%. 50% is perfect because that's going to give your plants enough humidity to thrive or at least get through the winter season without going overboard on the humidity. What can happen when it's really cold outside but really humid in our homes is that we can actually run into mold issues on our plants. So to try to make sure that that doesn't happen, let's keep it around 50%. Don't allow the temperature of your home to drop below 50 degrees Fahrenheit, 10 degrees Celsius, because of course most of our houseplants are tropical and they really don't like the cold. If you're comfortable in your home, your plants will be too. but it is so important that if you're going to be traveling or leaving your home, that you do not turn off your heat to save money, because you're going to come home to some very, very sad plants. Even though your plants may be resting, it's important that you stay vigilant. Because our homes tend to be drier in the winter, certain pests like spider mites and mealybugs can flourish out of nowhere. So at least once a week, make sure that you're giving each of your plants a thorough inspection so that no pest problems get out of control. Now, real quick before I tell you my final tip, I just wanted to thank you so much for being here. And if you want to increase your plant knowledge, go ahead and subscribe and hit that notification bell so that you don't miss out on anything. Okay, our final tip involves repotting. Now, if you can, hold off on repotting until the spring. In the springtime, when your plants are more active, they're gonna have a much easier time getting their roots down into that dirt quickly. Having said that though, if you have a plant that is in desperate need of repotting, it's looking sad or it's bursting out of something, don't wait. Don't wait until spring to repot it. It might not be the ideal time, but if your plant desperately needs it, it is the right time. Those are all the tips that I have for you today. I really hope that they were helpful. My name is Sam, this is Mind the Leaves, and always take care of your plants and yourself.